Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your man, Daniel T. Adams of PerhapsToday.net, and we are back with our first Bible speed art video of the year 2023. Let's check it out. So we're back. We're ready to do another Bible speed art, and I've got an awesome actor. His name is Joey. He's my nephew, and guess what, everybody? He's about to turn 12. I tried to do that backwards so you could see it. I don't know if that turns out right. But anyway, so if you're not familiar with him, don't worry. You're going to be, because he's hysterical. Cracks me up. But you might have seen him in this video right here. It was the picture we did for Kindness out of the Fruit of the Spirit Bible speed art series. Super excited to have him back. We're gonna get him in here. You guys ready? Let's go. Oh, ain't that something? Drums came in, you ain't see that coming. Hands on my head, can't tell me nothing. Got a taste of the fame, it'll pull my stomach. All right, this is Joey. That was a lot of fun. That was weird. I don't even know what that was, but this is Joey. Joey, say hi.
Hi.
Say hi even louder.
Hi.
Me, 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 me. Joey does not know what this picture is gonna be. However, I did show him the verse, or verses, that might be the theme for this picture. I'm going to give you guys a secret. You want to know a secret?
What?
This is a Bible speed art, but it might also be for somebody's birthday. But he didn't hear that, so did you hear anything?
No.
No? Look at the camera and be honest. Did you hear anything?
No.
I won't look. Go ahead and be honest. I don't know what just happened, but no, this kid is an awesome kid. Like I said earlier, he is turning 12. That means he's 1 year away from being a teenager. A teenager, everybody. So all you single ladies out there, holla! No, he's a great kid. He's got a huge heart. He is just a servant. He loves people. He loves helping people. He's also very organized. Sometimes I look at how well organized he is and I'm like, I should be more organized like that. Because I'm not. So, Joe, do you have anything that you want to say? I mean, your birthday's coming up. You know, you're doing another Bible speed art. This might be some picture for something else. Don't know. But do you have anything you want to say to the people at home watching?
I'm just glad to be back in Bible speed art. So.
And we're glad to have you back. So, without any delay, the theme for today is it's a neon theme. But for now, we're going to get set up. You see all the lights behind us. They're not neon lights. But maybe they might become, I don't know. Do you know, Joey? I don't know. Should we do the dance thing on the way out? All right, we're gonna do the dance thing. We'll see you guys later. The cinematic is beautiful, man. I don't know if I'm making movies or music videos. Videos, videos. Yeah, the sales can rise. Doesn't mean much, though, when your health declines. See, we've all got something that we trapped inside that we try to suffocate, you know, hoping it dies. Try to hold it underwater, but it always survives. And it comes up out of nowhere like an evil surprise. And it hovers over you to tell you.
It's so hard being an actor.
Must be as crazy as I'm. The point I'm making is the mind is a powerful place. And what you feed it can affect you in a powerful way. It's pretty cool, right? Yeah, but it's not always safe. Just hang with me. This will only take a moment, okay? Just think about it for a second. If you look at your face every day when you get up and think you'll never be great, you'll never be great. Not because you're not, but the hate will always find a way to cut you up and murder your faith. I've been developing, take a look at the benefits. Nothing to meddle with, I can never be delicate. My even relevant, that depends how you measure it. Take a measurement to back it up and give me the evidence. Pretty evident, dependable can never be tentative. I'm a gentleman, depending on if I think you're genuine. Pretty
evident. Joey, who's that cute little girl that you were sitting next to on the couch earlier?
Oh, that's my baby sister.
What's her name?
Her name's Chrissy.
And how old is she?
One week and a half, I think.
One and a half weeks? Okay. Yeah. You like having a baby sister?
Yeah.
She's a cutie.
Yeah.
Yeah. How does it feel now not being the cutest child in your family?
How dare you?
Thank you guys so much for being here for the first Bible speed art of the new year. What year is it, Joey?
2023.
All right. So now you've seen how we've taken the pictures. Now let's go for the Bible speed art portion. All right, Joey, you're going to sign us off by hitting the camera. Goodbye, everybody.
Bye.
All right, well, here we are, the first Bible Speed Art video of 2023, and I could not think of a better way to start it than when with my best buddy, Joey the Bear. He is turning 12 in February this year, and I wanted to do something that not only was going to be a picture for him for his birthday, but I wanted to do something that also would hopefully leave a lasting message for him, for myself, for the other kids of the family, as well as for all of you. So we decided to take this birthday present and turn it into the first Bible Speed Art of the video. So, hey, thanks so much for being here. I appreciate it. My favorite part of what we do at Perhaps Today, because this is the part where we look at the Word of God. Perhaps Today is not just about taking pictures. It's not just about digital art. Yes, we do that. Yes, it's a lot of fun. I really enjoy it. But the purpose of it is to tell a story visually using digital art to help hopefully draw out the concepts from God's Word. Because God's Word really can be broken down into the thought, the concept, and the appearance. The thought, well, it's just what it is. It's a thought. We all think thoughts all the time. You know, the world has thoughts, and it tries to fill our thoughts with their thoughts all of the time, unceasingly. And even nowadays in the world of digital media and social media, there's constant thoughts filling our head all the time as we swipe through, you know, Facebook or these social media platforms. I mean, thoughts from all over the world are constantly hitting our eyes and hitting our ears, and we're taking them in. But that's just a thought. See, Satan is good at thoughts. That's actually all he knows is thoughts. He's constantly dropping thoughts, whether it be through social media or regular media or Google or friends and family or people you work with. It's all over the place, but they're just thoughts. Whereas God's Word, when you apply the Holy Spirit to it, the Holy Spirit will reveal the concept. Matter of fact, the Holy Spirit is the only one who can teach concept. He puts the purpose to the thought. He puts the Spirit, wisdom, and understanding to the thought so that you understand the purpose behind it. And what does that do? It gives the appearance of who Christ is in your life and also who you are in Christ. What a phenomenal thing of what God's Word does. So for this picture, I'm calling it Escape the Neon City, as you see the city being built in the background, because the Neon City is representative in this picture of the world. It's shiny, it's bright, and from the outside, it looks very appealing. It offers money, it offers fame, it offers, you know, alcohol, as you see that big neon sign being added to the front of the building. It adds all kinds of flashiness. Matter of fact, it can be whatever you want it to be. And it can be one way today, and it can be something different tomorrow. But see, that is called relative truth. It's what I like to call the buffet line of truth. It's you pick and choose whatever works for your situation. But I'm here to tell you, that is not godly. There's one source of godly truth. There's one source of truth, period. It's called sound doctrine. It is called the Word of God. And so the verses I wanted to look at for my buddy Joey, for me and my own life, and for you, comes from the 119th chapter of Psalm. It is in verse 105, and it says, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light for my path. I have taken an oath and confirmed it that I will follow your righteous laws. I have suffered much. Preserve my life, O Lord, according to your word." I love that scripture. I love all the scripture around it. Matter of fact, the 119th chapter of Psalm is all about the Word of God. But what I love about this is that there's one lamp for your feet, the one light to reveal the path that you should take. There's a narrow road and a wide road. We learn that from Jesus in the book of Matthew. Which road are you on? And if you are on a road that's got a bunch of bumps and things and obstacles, how are you going to know not to trip over those things? Well, you need a light. And what God is clearly spelling out for us is that there's one truth that will light your way. There's one truth that will be a lamp for your feet to not stumble. Are you tired of stumbling in life? Maybe you're stumbling over addictions. Maybe you're stumbling over being blinded by what the world has to offer, like the neon city. Well, stop using the neon lights. Use the light from the Word of God. And what I love here, even at the end of the verses I read in verse 107, it says, yeah, I've suffered. Preserve my life, O Lord. But it doesn't say, see, we all pray that. Oh, God, give me health. Give me healing. I need this. I want this. You know, preserve my life. But what he adds is according to your word. even the preservation of our life and the longevity of our life, however many years or days that might be, should be according to the Word of God. Not according to what the world says is politically correct. Not according to what the world says is truth, as you see the sign being put onto this big dome that will eventually say, "Welcome to Relative City." Because all the world offers is relative truth. It's ironically a theory of relativity. But absolute truth is only found in the Word of God. Matter of fact, 2 Timothy 3:16 and 17 says, "All scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness." If life is spiraling out of control for you, if you're struggling with addictions, if you're struggling with all kinds of different things that you know are not right, that you know are not pleasing to the Lord, then where are you finding your truth? What are you holding on to? Where's your anchor? Is it in the cool neon lights, or is it sitting out in the rocks, lighting a path for you? But you need to be willing to take it. You need to be willing to use the right light for the job. See, the problem is we want to live in Relative City. We want to live under the glow of the neon lights. And we want to try to fit God into our world. We want to stay in the city, but say, "All right, God, I want you to be in my world, but according to my way." Whereas what I see from Psalm 119 is that it should be according to your word, O Lord. It should be according to your will, O God. And there's nothing else that gives us his truth than his word. We literally have the heart of God Almighty in our hands when we hold our Bible. And yet, do we treat it as such? Do we treat it as the heart of God, or do we treat it as a book and we'll pull it down sometimes and maybe we read it every day, but are we studying it? Maybe we study it, but are we applying what we're learning? Are we truly seeking his will from it? Are we trying to pull the concept from it, allowing the Spirit really to teach the concept? And then applying it to our life so that we can have the appearance of Christ. And the cool thing about it is when you are obedient to the concepts of God through the Spirit, you will actually be the appearance of Christ for somebody else. So as you see, Joey here in the picture has escaped the neon city because he's following the true light. He can be an example to somebody else. So look, if you're tired of being addicted to what the neon city has to offer, today is the day you can escape. The Word of God is lighting your path. It is a lamp for your feet. Will you follow it? So as we wrap up here, I want to say, Joey, happy birthday. Dude, I love you so much. You are an awesome kid. Remember, the neon world will always chase you down. It will always be there to drop thoughts into your head. But remember that the Word of God and the Spirit of God will teach you his concepts and teach you his heart and how much he loves and adores you and the great purpose he has for your life. And the same goes for all of you listening. So thank you so much for tuning into this first Bible Speed Art of 2023. If you are in need of prayer, please reach out to us at our website at perhapstoday.net and let us know how we can better serve you in prayer. Or maybe you know someone who can be encouraged by this video. If so, please share it with them. These videos are meant to be shared, and we will share it because we are the church. Thank you so much. God bless.
I get down. I was lost, now I'm found. It's been a hell of a ride, now everything's new in town.